didn't tell me to know.
That's the photo ID.
Photo ID.
There you go.
Thank you, Kathy. My name is Travis. I will be your bartender and server on our way up to Talkeetna today. I'm just going to let you all know a little bit about how breakfast and lunch service works on this train. First things first, everybody is assigned a tab at their table by where they are seated. I do have some open tables right now, so when we get going here before I start service, if anybody needs a little bit more room, anybody can't face backwards or anything like that, and would like to take one of these tables that's open, feel free to go to the club car. But for ordering and purchasing during the time, I ask that you do that at the same position the entire time. Also, you have two menus on your table. There's a large one that says dining menu, and there's a small one that says bistro car. The one that we order off of in this car is the dining menu. That is what I have available for you today in this car. If you'd like anything off of the little orange one that says bistro car, that bistro car is conveniently located right next to us today. You just go through those air doors into the next car over, and that is the bistro car.
Down here, I think these ladies who are teachers will look up, and then it can be passed around through the train car. You can see what a different lifestyle might have been for a young people coming to Alaska in the 70s or 80s. One of the things in Alaska is everybody loves to wave at the train, so if you see people waving at you,
if you look out here now, this where your cruise ship is sitting is a body of water called Passage Canal. This water is always ice free.
We should probably get water.
No matter what, how cold the temperature is, this Passage Canal never freezes. It's a fjord, actually. You see the buoys out here? People have dropped these buoys. They're not commercial fishing, but they're just setting a buoy out with a shrimp pot at the bottom of it. The shrimp will go in, and they can go out in a small little boat, pull it in by hand, and they can have shrimp for dinner. So that's what those pots, those buoys are. They're attached to basically shrimp pots. As high as that mountain is, that's how deep the water goes in Passage Canal. So Whittier has a very deep port that's open to the Gulf of Alaska, eventually into the Pacific Ocean. Makes it a very desirable port, but the one thing that has always been when they pave over where the tracks are, so the tracks are receded into a pavement, so that cars and the train use this tunnel. When we get into the tunnel, you'll see the tunnel is only the size of this rail car. There's no room on the sides for anybody to walk. This is a single lane going through the mountain. So we'll have a turn to go through the mountain. So we'll have a turn. The tunnel pretty much runs east and west because we haven't headed north yet. And so when we're heading to the west, welcome to the Anton Anderson Tunnel. You can see on both sides that's all the wire this is. It's high enough to accommodate the double decker, like a Vista Dome car, but there's no room on the sides. This tunnel goes through a solid granite mountain, and it's was constructed in 1943. Why they're like that is because the trees are pickled. This is what they are. This land subsided during the Great Alaska Earthquake in 1964. It sank between 6 and 8 feet. And the roots of these trees decayed after the salt water sucked up into the tree itself. And the trees were actually pickled is what they were. So for 49 years, these trees have just stood like that. They don't deteriorate. They don't blow down in the tremendous winds they get through here. And we'll see more examples of the earth as we travel in history. All this side of the mountains subsided. A lot of the land subsided or sank. This area.
They have returned enough into the north arm that there may be beluga whales. There have been beluga whales in there for the past week.
Swans and geese nest in them. It's an extensive area to live in the Anchorage around the Little Lagoon but now it's the oldest subdivision or oldest residential property in the city of Anchorage. Even though many of the homes aren't that fancy, it's very expensive property. This is the most expensive residential property you can buy in Anchorage itself. Just because the homes aren't luxurious, but they're actually within walking distance. All of these containers are these large metal containers. Everything we eat, dry, and wear in South Central Alaska comes from those containers. They say the only thing that flies into Anchorage or this area are mail and sheep. But it's too expensive to fly most of your merchandise in, so it comes in containers. Across the Gulf of Alaska, occasionally those containers get bumped around and are knocked off one time or something.
We didn't do the all-day training either.
200 Toyotas went down the bottom of the Gulf of Alaska. Because our cars come that way too, you can see those containers.
In Anchorage, a princess tour.
Disembarking in Anchorage, I'm going to come and help those people in just a moment. So you stop a moment or two, and you can see all of these containers over there.
It came 15 years ago, and she didn't remember where she said it. Well, there is.
Larger mountain that's a little bit to the left of that.
Can't wait to look down because a lot of people don't see my camera. We're not even picking up anything.
But, yeah, in fact, my sister
training. This area is different than the panel. Some areas, there's patches of them. Some areas have permafrost, some don't. And permafrost means that if you took a shovel and went out there and dug, in about 2 feet, you can run into the ice or permanently frozen ground. So these trees are called in Russia.
These folks are going where you just came from, and you're going where they came from. Okay, folks, my name is John. We are going into the small town of Talkeetna. Those of you that have not made up your mind whether you want to stay in Talkeetna, I would like to encourage you to do that for more than one reason. If you go to the lodge and then come back, if you do not have a tour, it will cost you $10 to get a ticket to come back into town. Also, I wish that we could say tomorrow will be as beautiful as today is. And so, I would suggest that you just go in town. If you just want to spend 1 hour, walk around and look, grab you a bite to eat. We have coaches leaving from Talkeetna every hour on the half hour. So, the next one will be leaving at 1:30. They leave from 1:30 until 7:30 tonight. Then at 9 o'clock tonight, the last coach leaves from Talkeetna. But we will get down to the parking lot, all of these coaches, and depending on how many people stay on here or not, they will move. They might move you to another coach or something if you want to go back to the lodge at this time. We will not know until we get the numbers and everything, but all the all the luggage and stuff that carry-on stuff that you put underneath that has been tagged, it will be taken to the lodge. It will be put in the luggage room there. So whenever you come back from Talkeetna, just hold on to the little piece that you tore off, and they will have your carry-on luggage for you there. Of course, the other luggage that you sent on ahead, it will be in your room sometime today. But Talkeetna is a small town, probably around 800. There are many tourists that go out of there. I know some of you will be going fishing today. A beautiful day for that. There are tours here that are available, such as zip line or rafting or riding a jet boat. I don't know what tours you have scheduled. Of course, your tour might be tomorrow. But as I was saying, this is a good opportunity for you to get off and just walk through town. You can walk all over town in 15 minutes. There's a few places that I would recommend that you go to see. One would be the museum, which is whenever you get off the coach, you will go up to the highway, take a right, and walk to town. Whenever you see the stop sign, that is the main street of town there. But before we get there, you will notice on the left is the post office. There's a little gravel road that goes beside the post office. Behind that post office is a hangar. And they have public restrooms there. Behind, that's Don Shelton's hangar. Don Shelton was a famous bush pilot. But behind his hangar is the Talkeetna Museum. It was a schoolhouse at one time that they have turned into a museum. I think tickets for that to go in and look are around $8, I believe. Don't hold me to that, but I think it's what they are. And also behind the museum, just go on down that little street, is the ranger station. Everyone that climbs a mountain has to check in there. Officially, the climbing season is over, but they have all kind of information about those that have climbed it this year. About we had one man to break the record for age-wise this time, and they have all that information there. Also, they show a short film there about the mountain, but they have a lot of interesting facts about the mountain. In the museum, I didn't tell you, but they have like a 12-foot replica of Denali, Mount McKinley, the whole mountain range there. And then they have a lot of other interesting things dealing with the town of Talkeetna. One thing that I would recommend, if you have the opportunity, is whenever you get on Main Street, is just keep walking till you come to the river. I will show you as we come into town, there are three rivers that meet in Talkeetna. I went out this morning to see it. I came in about 7 o'clock here this morning, or 8 o'clock. I left the garage at 7 o'clock. And the mountains, Denali, Mount McKinley, and all the mountains are behind that with the snow and everything. It is just gorgeous. And in fact, I turned around and walked back almost a mile to get to where my coach was so I could get my camera and go back and take pictures. And so I would highly recommend that you do that today. The weather changes fast. Denali, McKinley creates his own weather. And it changes, so anytime that you have an opportunity to see the mountain, take pictures, do it then. But there are a lot of eating places in Talkeetna, a lot of gift shops also. And if you just want to grab a burger quickly, there's Shirley's Burgers right there to the left where I let you off at. Prince's has the office right there across the road from the parking lot also. For those of you that are staying, just remember, like I said, the coaches leave every hour on the half hour, but be sure to be back maybe 5 to 10 minutes before that half hour so that you can get on. And also, be sure to ask the coach driver. You see the mountain right there in front of you, the top of it. But be sure to ask that driver if he is going to McKinley Prince's Lodge. There are other coaches that use this same parking lot that we do. So, don't want you to end up some other place. for those of you that brought backpacks on that you have not tagged, you know, if you change your mind and want to go on, stay here, I can give you a tag and tag that and send that on. Or you can put it, McHay's Jet Boat Service, which is right next to the parking lot, they will store anything for you for a dollar a day. So your backpack, they will store it for you. And of course, if you were taking a tour or something, they would probably do it also if you were flying or doing some of these things. Any questions? You will notice just as soon as I turn the curve, well, you see the mountain range there. But as I turn here, you will see where the three rivers meet. And then you can see the mountains in the background. Just a real beautiful sight. It's probably as pretty today as I have seen it. They say only 20-30% of the people that come through here actually see what you're seeing right now. Highest point in North America is right in front of you, 20,320 feet. In fact, 17 of the 20 tallest mountains in North America are here in Alaska. Another thing that I would, here comes the plane right over the top of us. You see to the right, our K2 Aviation flies right out there. They land on the glacier, they fly up around the summit. But another thing that you probably should do is go meet the mayor of Calcutta while you're here. You will find him at the West Rift Restaurant, 1997. Because nobody wanted any of the other people that were running for mayor to be their mayor, so they decided to start a write-in campaign. Everyone said they wanted Stubbs to be their mayor, and he was elected by a great majority today, 2013. No one has dared run against him, and he is very famous. He is cute. He has four legs and a short tail. And he's a cat, and I will pass a picture around. And while you're in that general store, you need to buy that postcard, because whenever you get back home and tell people about the mayor of Calcutta, they will not believe it. But that is proof there. There's the mayor. Just pass it around and back down.